This is a day the Lord has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad therein. We just want to welcome you into the beautiful sanctuary of the historic St. James Episcopal Church, where we welcome you. We are glad that you are following along with us and that we will be back to service real soon. Our annual meeting is on February the 13th, along with our first real Sunday celebration, and then we will continue on through the year as much as we are allowed to. Beginning February 20th, all our services are at 9:30 in the morning. I also welcome you in the name of our sister church, the Episcopal Church of St. Michael and All Angels, located at 2013 St. Paul Street in Baltimore, Maryland. Won't you enjoy our wonderful worship this morning? And let us know by subscribing to our YouTube page and also letting us know by email or telephone how much you enjoyed our services. God bless you and be safe. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you govern all things, both in heaven and on earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of your people, and in our time grant us your peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
The Old Testament reading is from Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. And before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations." Then I said, "Ah, Lord God, truly I do not know how to speak, for I am only a boy." But the Lord said to me, "Do not say I am only a boy, for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and you shall speak whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said to me, "Now I have put my words in your mouth. See, today I appoint you over nations and over kingdoms, to pluck up and to pull down, to destroy and to overthrow, to build and to plant. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Thanks be to God. The Psalm 71. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed. In your righteousness, deliver me and set me free. Incline your ear to me and save me. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. You are my crag and my stronghold. Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evildoer and the oppressor. For you are my hope, O Lord God, my confidence since I was young. I have been sustained by you ever since I was born. From my mother's womb, you have been my strength. My praise shall always be of you. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The New Testament reading is from 1 Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesize only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these is love. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Thanks be to God.
Give me Jesus.
Jesus Christ, according to Luke. Jesus began to say to them, "Today the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." All spoke well of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They said, "Is this not Joseph's son?" He said to them, "Doubtless you will quote me this proverb, 'Doctor, cure yourself.' And you will say, 'Do here also in your hometown the things that we have heard you did at Capernaum.'" And he said, "Truly I tell you, no prophet is accepted in the prophet's hometown. But the truth is, there were many widows in Israel in the time of Elijah, when the heaven was shut up 3 years and 6 months, and there was a severe famine over all the land. Yet Elijah was sent to none of them except to the widow at Zarephath in Sidon. There were also many lepers in Israel in the time of the prophet Elisha, and none of them was cleansed except Naaman the Syrian." When they heard this, all in the synagogue were filled with rage. They got up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town was built, so that they might hurl him off the cliff. But he passed through the midst of them and went on his way. The gospel of the Lord.
I will come praising the mighty deeds of the Lord God. I will praise your righteousness and yours alone. O God, from my youth you have taught me, and I still proclaim your wondrous deeds. So even to old age and gray hairs, O God, do not forsake me, until I proclaim your might to all the generations to come. Your powers and your righteousness, O God, reach the high heavens. You who have done great things, O God, who is like you? Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. What a pleasure it is to be with you today, historic St. James and St. Michael's and All Angels Episcopal Churches. What a pleasure it has been to be sent by the historic St. James Episcopal Church to seminary, and to be supported in my call to the priesthood by a parish who has lifted several to the highest. What a pleasure it is to stand in the pulpit and proclaim the word of God to you, holy people, who support me, who love me, and encourage me in my endeavors to walk in the way of the Lord and orient others in that sacred and holy way. Since I was young, I've always wanted to be like one of the prophets of the Old Testament. Sometimes I even had the nerve to voice this aspiration out loud. My grandfather was a pastor and a preacher. He'd laugh and ask, "Son, are you sure you want to drink from this cup?" With my head held high and my chest poked out, I always answered yes. As I learned more about the prophets, though, that yes became more and more tempered. But who wouldn't want to be like a prophet? Well, it turns out, many of the other prophets didn't want to be prophets at first. My friends, in ancient times and even today, the prophetic life was and remains not an easy one. One could even say it had to be downright miserable, lonely, dangerous, terrifying, and even humiliating to be a prophet. Prophets were ignored. They were hated, harassed, beaten, and exiled, and killed. They still are. Being a prophet was hard. The scripture is a witness to that very fact. For example, frustration with his prophetic mission disqualified Moses from entering the promised land. Elijah was chased out of Israel and even threatened and haunted by Jezebel. Poor Ezekiel had to lay on his side for more than a year and eat food cooked over dung as a warning to the people for the consequences of their sins. And you remember Hosea? He was commanded to have a wife and children of whoredom for a land that committed great whoredom by forsaking the Lord God. Today, we even heard of another example in our gospel reading involving Jesus, whose prophetic utterances almost got him thrown off a cliff. Jeremiah's life was no different. Things were so bad for him, he is known as the weeping prophet. His prophetic mission brought him tremendous hardship and much sadness. He was a man filled with anguish. He was wounded and isolated, broken like the people of Judah on the verge of a devastation and catastrophic proportions. He suffered for and with his people. He lamented for himself and his people. He suffered as he watched his people forsake the love of each other and a God who pursued his people relentlessly. But the Spirit of God burned in Jeremiah like a fire. A fire so strong that he continued his prophetic mission despite his suffering, heartbreak, and hardship. Importantly, God's promises to Jeremiah were never broken. God also kept his promises to the covenant people to build and to plant. The call story we heard today in the Old Testament reading foreshadowed the difficult task that stood before Jeremiah, and it also illuminated God's faithful commitment to the people chosen and loved by God. God's commitment to humanity has not changed in the least. Maybe God doesn't call every person to be a prophet like Jeremiah, but I believe that God calls everyone to be prophetic. Not prophetic in the sense that we are to report God's actions in the future, but prophetic in the sense that we are supposed to speak the truth to power and live those truths in the world. Looking out in the world today, it appears that we may be falling short of God's call for us, including the church. We are not called to watch oppression in the world and say and do nothing. We are not called to watch the cycles of empire, of greed, materialism, nationalism, capitalism, ravage and destroy marginalized and oppressed people and our environment and say and do nothing. We are not called to watch mass incarceration, deportation, demonization, and separation of people of colors and their families, and say and do nothing. We are not called to place blame on victims caught in the cycles of sin under the guise of white supremacy and law and order, and say and do nothing. We are not called to live in luxury and comfort while others starve, freeze, and remain in need of life's bare and basic necessities. We are not called to watch racism, homophobia, sexism, and other prejudice and bigoted attitudes and policies that destroy and diminish the dignity and lives of our siblings who are created in the same image of God that we believe resides in our very beings and do nothing. We were not created to live and be as individuals who live life without consideration and when the quality of lives around them are awful and terrible. We We know this. I know we know this. But looking out into the world, we must know that we must do better. So in so many ways, as Christians and members of the church, we are called to serve God with the single-mindedness and intensity of Jeremiah and other prophets, regardless of the cost. Yes, it is the same one of the crosses that Jesus challenges us to bear. It is the same cross that comes with difficulties but leads to freedoms unimaginable for everyone. It is the same cross that Jesus died on and with whom we die to become God's people who answers God's call in the affirmative, yes. If we read our scriptures closely, we can be assured that God is not only with us, but has created us specifically and specially to help the oppressed go free and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor every day. Yes, my friends, living as children of God and followers of Jesus in this world is not easy. But as God did for Jeremiah, God knows us, sets us apart, appoints us to participate in God's kingdom and God's dream for us. Yes, we are fearfully and wonderfully made, not to serve ourselves, but to serve only God who knew us before we were formed. Like Jeremiah, we are not children, we are not helpless. We are equipped by God through the Holy Spirit to live into our special call. There will be times when we feel like quitting, and when we do, we must remember the words of Jeremiah when he said, "If I say, I will not make mention of God, nor speak any more in God's name, then there in my heart, a burning fire will shut up in my bones that I cannot contain." Like Jeremiah and with God's help, we are called to act in this world, to pluck and pull down, to destroy and overthrow greed, individualism, violence, oppression, hate, and other deeply rooted sins that destroy our communities, the human souls, and God's beautiful creation. Like Jeremiah, and with God's help, we are called to build and plant the beloved community by following Jesus and acting and living into a radical love, like that one we heard in today's epistle reading. Building a world with Jesus filled with flourishing lives, lives dedicated as living sacrifices to God's kingdom. And let the church say, amen.
There.
Such a wonderful sermon, let us affirm our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made. Of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray the prayers of the people, Form 4 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world, especially to our presiding Bishop Michael Bruce Curry, our diocesan Bishop Eugene Taylor, our assistant Bishop Robert Eloff, for Father Meadows and for our deacon Nathaniel Gibson, Natalie Tenner, our seminarians, Herschel Wade, Donna Sweeney, and David Smith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good, especially the vestry and ministry leaders of this church. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give us all reverence for the earth and for your creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless all those whose lives have been deeply linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ with them and in them, and love one another as he loves us. We pray for the members of this church, especially for those who are unable to attend regularly. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit. Give them the courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them to the joy of your salvation. We pray for the people of the suffering who are suffering through the storms of life, especially Vanessa, Diane, Natalie, Patricia, Derek, Juanita, Leslie, Arthurline, Josephine, Sarah, Cordella, Lorraine, Connie, Kim, Leah, Ryan, Janice, Clarence, Luther, Candy, and Jerry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We commend to your mercy all who have died, for Robert Murphy Matthews, for Calvin Anderson Sr., for Tammy Hicks and Paulette Thompson, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear our voices, hear our cries, hear our songs, Lord, because we look to the hills from whence cometh our help, knowing our help comes from the Lord. Lord, and we ask, O God, that you hear us, O lover of our souls, and grant us your mercy according to your will. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, this is our prayer. Amen.
Let's confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you of all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you. First of all, I'd like to thank you for your faithfulness and for the way you have given to both churches during this time of the pandemic. Our offerings and our monies that we receive all go to the ministries of this church. And we hope you are confident that our vestries and our boards and our members are doing God's will with your resources. Give us your time, give us your treasure, give us your talent. It all goes to the glory and honor of God. You may give electronically, you may give to St. Michael's through Cash App, $SMMA Church. You may also give to St. James Episcopal Church through pushpay.com, St. James Episcopal Church. Or you may mail your offerings right directly to the church, 2013 St. Paul, 21218 for St. Michael's and 1020 West Lafayette Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21217 for St. James. We ask you to walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself as an offering and a sacrifice unto God, our offertory.
As a shadow of a cross
To give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Because of the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people, the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on them in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Thank you. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God our Savior be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.